Hi, this is Danica, and I design WordPress membership site. So in this series, we are learning about LearnDash LMS and how to set up your course with it. In this video, we will be checking out the groups tab in the course page and what's its usage, how it works. Now, before diving in here, of course, we need to go to LearnDash LMS and then there's a groups. We need to understand this section first because this part is just simply assigning which group does this course belongs to. But its settings is actually under LearnDash LMS and then groups. So in this page, we have, I'm just gonna move everything to trash so that it's clean. But we have an add new button and an actions. And in here, you could actually assign group categories, group tags, WordPress categories, WordPress tags. So depending on how you need to organize this, these are available for you to like use for tagging and filtering your groups. Now there's two tabs in here. We have groups and the settings. In the settings, there is group leader user settings, and actually this is like one of the biggest usage of the groups. So you could have a group leader, and then that group leader could manage their own groups, course, and even users. And then there's a group hierarchy, group table pagination, group courses order, and more in here. Now, if I example add a new group, so let's just say group A, test, and it's like the course editor. It has some blocks and functionality on the side. So if we check in here, these are just default WordPress stuff. But on the settings, it's like a course. They allow you to set the access mode. Could be like free, buy now, or closed. And then there's also some group materials and group certificate that you could assign. So it's actually like a mimic or exactly the same with the course. It's just different functionality because the groups holds courses and it could be more than one. So example here on the course tab, we could say that in this group, I want this two course to be in this group. So let's just say I'm gonna select that two and then move that in here. So that means these courses belongs to group A test. And then whatever settings I set in here is gonna override those settings that you set in the course. So do note on that one. I'm gonna show you how it looks from the back end later. There's also an option here that says group courses auto-enroll. So if you enable this, it says enable automatic group enrollment when a user enrolls into any associated group course. So let's just say I'm gonna remove any of this, but if I say if a user enrolled, so I'm gonna check this. So if I check this, whatever example, if I have this course, right? But I don't have this other one. So whenever I'm enrolled to this one, automatically they will be associated to this group. So that's how it works. Enable automatic group enrollment when a user enrolls to an associated group course. But what I could also do is, example, I could also select manually. So let's just say I have number of courses here and I'm gonna just select this. So, and then this one does not belong in here, right? But I'm saying here that if they are enrolled to this course, I also want them to be automatically enrolled to this group. And automatically they are gonna get this course additionally. So you need to be careful when setting up this course, group course auto-enrollment, because in my experience, I have mistakenly set this up before and it created a problem. So make sure to review this section. only most of the time only this first part is what you need, but depending again on your setup, you may need to configure this. So here I'm gonna publish this, and how it's gonna look is example on the back end, creating LearnDash course groups. As you can see, we did not assign this earlier, right? But we created this course, this group, and we selected this course as the group courses, and automatically that's gonna link the course in here. Now if I say and go to the settings, there's a warning message in here. It says this course is part of a group. Group settings will override course settings for any users enrolled in the group. So example, if you say here that it's free, but in your group it says it's, let's just say, paid, then this is the highest hierarchy. So it's gonna prioritize the settings in here compared to the core settings, access mode settings you set in here. So do note on that one. Maybe if I fill in more details in this demo site, we could like demonstrate how this exactly works. But for now, if you have any question regarding this part, something confuses you, let me know and I am gonna do my best to get back to you on that one. Next is the users tab. In the users tab, we will be seeing all of the users enrolled to the group, and also whoever is the leader of the group. Do note that you could assign more than one leader for the group, and the leader can do a lot. Like they could manage this group, and they could even create their own courses if you allow them to. So if you want to enroll someone to this group, you can just select their name, move it to the next box, and that's it. And let's just say I'm the leader of this one, so I'm gonna move it on the next box as well, and then update. So that is LearnDash LMS groups, and it's not like we could do more testing how this exactly works, but in my opinion, I use groups for different scenarios. Like example, if you are offering a license, company license, so you could create some groups for those companies and have them access number of courses in your website. You could also allow some group leaders to create their courses, but the not so nice thing about that is group leader, if they log in, so let's just say I'm gonna try to make this as a group leader so that you could imagine it. So group leader, and then on the groups, I'm gonna make that the leader. And then on the group settings, we're gonna allow some stuff for them. So we will allow them to manage courses. We're also gonna allow them to manage groups, and this one as well. And I'm gonna switch using that user, but to be able to do that, I'm gonna first install a plugin user switch. So that I don't need to like log in manually. So now I could switch to, and that's a group leader, right? So I'm gonna switch to, and as you can see, the group leader has access to the LearnDash stuff. But example, we set it that only the ones that they have created, so they can view this, but they can't edit it. But it says they can clone it. On the lessons, they can again view all of this. And the reason for that is these are like free. If we make this close, I doubt that they could. But example here on the groups, I could like, one problem with this is if I go to, if I'm company A and I create my group, what's gonna happen is I could see the complete list of users in this website. Now, maybe that's fine for you, but for most of my clients, they don't like that. So we ended up not using the group functionality because of this side. Now, we could, of course, hide the section. We've actually tried that, hiding it via code, but it was still risky for them. So we haven't used this one, but that's one of the problems that I see. Maybe they could, what they want is only to see the users that belongs to this group. So, but in this case, it's actually listing all of the users in your website. So that's gonna be a problem for most of projects. So I hope that this video helps and explains the course and the course groups and how to like set up one and why is it in here, what's its usage. And if you have any question, of course, please comment it down below and I'll do my best to answer your question. Thanks.